Open a colourful image in Affinity Photo, PC or Mac, and go to Filters and Distort and Equations. Go to the X field and set a value, say 300, 390, whatever, just to get a nice colourful design like that, showing this gradient right across the screen. Set the Y to equal Y. You can, of course, if you want to, vary that as well. You can actually turn around and say, well, you know what, I want it times 5. And that just puts it right at the top of the screen, which you might not want. However, what you can also do, extend mode. Extend mode, go to mirror, and you can see what happens. It mirrors this design. And of course, you can vary this, the X. I can say, you know what, let's go for 300, just try something else. Or maybe 200. So you've got that design, and you can, of course, change it. You don't have to have 5, you can have 6, 7, 8, etc. And like I say, mirror there. And click apply. Once you've got that, what you can do, you can go to the layers panel and there's a little padlock. So you just see a little padlock there, click there, and so it's not selected anymore. And then you can resize this design. I'm just going to resize it, make it really crunched in. You can see the whites, the blues, etc. But what I'm now going to do is I'm going to duplicate this, but I'm going to use a special duplication. I'm just going to go for layer and duplicate linked. So layer and duplicate linked, and that creates another layer. And you can see that's a special one because it's got a little link there. And you can modify this using various filters as well. And you can also resize it, scale it, so you can just scale it like this. And that doesn't affect the actual linking. They don't all change. You can just change that. And then again, duplicate linked again. You can set up a shortcut, just make it easier. I haven't at this moment, so just do that. And you can also rotate it, maybe apply shears, and so on and so on. So you can create a couple of these layer, and duplicate linked, and again, another one. What you can also do is select all of them, go to the layers panel there, and go to layer and duplicate linked. And you can see you get these all linked, and that's the key thing. So once you've got that, you can resize these, move these around. Just gonna do that. Just resize that one, go that way, and so on. You can do, just create a variety of different designs using this, and they're all identical. So when you apply a filter, they all change. So you can just go now to filters, and you need one selected. So one selected, just go down to distort, and I'm going to go for shear, because I want to create a wave effect. Now, don't use this one. You can if you want to, of course, but you can just use this one mainly. And you can see as you change that, they all change. So you can just click there and just add some points. And as you do that, you can see every single one of them alter. You can get some very dramatic sort of effects just by doing that. And you just put that there. And of course, you could have 50 layers. You could have 100 layers. Might be a bit slower, but you could certainly have lots and lots of layers. And you can stretch it up. You can always go back to those and resize that. And click apply. And there you have it. Very quick design. Nice wavy design with multiple. However, you can also go to effects just down there, maybe go for an outer shadow, and they will all have exactly the same outer shadow. So you can just see the design there. And of course, you can modify the angle as well, so you can create a nice effect on that. And they all change as well. So you've got a lovely wavy design, very quickly created that way. And of course, you can apply other filters as well. I'm just going to go say filters, maybe go to blur or distort, maybe use deform, or maybe go to shear again. You can always do that again. So again, select that and then modify that. And you can see as you do that, that waves will all change as well. You could use deform, you could use perspective, all useful for creating all kinds of weird and wonderful designs like this. I'm just gonna just stretch this off in all kinds of different angles. Unfortunately, you can't drag this panel out. It'd be really great if you could stretch this panel out a bit more. You can't, but there you can create that and click apply. And you can see you can create multiple different designs using that. Now you shift around. Now sometimes, and I found this in some of the things, it cuts them off. Clearly with duplicate linked, it doesn't in this case. But if you suddenly, I always try and make certain it's not cutting it off, because it might just suddenly find the top has been chopped or the bottom. And you can move that around, and you can still continue to resize it as well. So you can select those layers and resize those layers if you want to, because you might have something that you think, oh, that's slightly wrong position. Just reposition it. And again, if you want, You can always go back and you can always go again. Filters, maybe use one of the other ones. Deform, just use deform instead. As long as you've got a layer selected and all of them will deform at the same time. So you can create some very weird and wonderful wavy, distorted designs just by doing this. And again, let's just bring that up so you can see the panel. You can use similarity is another option, or rigid. I like to vary just to see which one works, looks nicer. Once you're happy with that, click apply. And you can see you've got a nice wavy design created very quickly in Affinity Photo. If you've got any questions, please put some comments below. Always appreciated. Anything that I've sort of maybe went too quick, maybe too didn't explain well enough. Do you think, oh, I missed that? Also, of course, you can always rewind the video, have a quick check again. You can always, of course, slow the video down. Quite often people say, well, I always put it at half speed. That's even easier. Also, like or dislike, always appreciated. Thank you much.